This is an original one-sheet poster from 1940 for the film starring Raymond Massey and Ruth Gordon, Abe Lincoln in Illinois. This poster was creased with machine folio fulls, and we flattened it out with a linen backing at Posterfix. Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome back to another edition of Posterfix Studio.
When we got Abe Lincoln in Illinois, it was folded. It's got these folio creases in them because movie posters were usually folded, machine folds, and distributed to the theaters or to the National Screen Service, who distributed them to the theaters. The poster is dry, but it's not faded. The color is very rich. There are breaks in the folds at this intersection and at this intersection and at the bottom of the poster. And we're going to linen back this straight away.
This poster, once it was printed, was machine folded, and that's the way it was distributed to the theaters from the printers. All original, authentic National Screen Service posters are distributed this way, for the most part, unless they're printed on cardstock or for some other reason, which occurs with odd sizes. So linen backing is a process that helps us flatten out the poster. It is a process where we take the vintage poster, we add wheat paste to the back, and mount it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. This has the effect of prolonging the longevity of the paper, helping to neutralize the acids, as well as giving it a firm base so that it's stronger and easier to handle and frame. Abe Lincoln in Illinois is a 1940 biographical historical drama film that depicts the life of Abraham Lincoln from his departure from Kentucky until his election as President of the United States. In the United Kingdom, the film is known by the alternate title, Spirit of the People. The film was adapted by Grover Jones and Robert E. Sherwood from Sherwood's Pulitzer Prize-winning play of the same name. It was directed by John Cromwell. The film stars Raymond Massey and Howard Da Silva, who reprised their roles from the original Broadway production of Abe Lincoln in Illinois, playing Abe Lincoln and Jack Armstrong, respectively. Herbert Rudley, who had portrayed Seth Gale in the play, also repeated his role in the film version. The film also marks the screen debut of Ruth Gordon in the role of Mary Todd Lincoln. The film received Academy Award nominations for Best Actor in a Leading Role, Raymond Massey, and Best Cinematography, Black and White, James Wong Howe.
Well, we've got Abe Lincoln linen backed.
Don't go away, we'll be right back.
When the spoilers came to us, it had heavy creased folio folds, the way one sheets are always distributed from the printer folded. But it also had a big rip along the folio fold going up, but almost halfway up the poster, and other breaks here, and pinhole, missing paper in the intersection. So we're going to linen back it. It's going to share a screen with Gene Autry.
This film poster is also a one sheet. It's from 1930, and it has the same kind of folio fold damage that the Abe Lincoln poster had, which is sharing the screen with it. The spoilers is a 1930 American pre-code Western film directed by Edwin Kerwee and starring Gary Cooper, Kay Johnson, and Betty Compson. Set in Nome, Alaska, during the 1898 gold rush, the film is about a gold prospector and a corrupt Alaska politician who fight for control over the gold mine. The film features a spectacular saloon fist fight between Cooper and William Stage Boyd.
Well, we've got the spoilers linen back now. Gary Cooper is flattened out. Looks pretty good, almost like there's no damage at all. We'll go in and restore this stuff after it dries. Gene Autry doesn't need much work. Gene Autry is flat and looks nice. Abe Lincoln looks flat and looks nice. RKO Radio Pictures copyright and the RKO Radio Pictures logo adorn this poster for Abe Lincoln in Illinois. This is a Paramount picture, and here is the Paramount logo. This is a Republic picture, and here is the Republic logo.
Don't go away. We'll be right back. This poster is printed on very thin paper. It's different paper because this is European paper. This is a French poster advertising an entertainer in the 1930s, and the poster paper tends to absorb the wheat paste very quickly, but it doesn't have the same resilience as the American poster paper. However, it does have the benefit of not seeming to want to rip as easily, so perhaps it's a bit stronger despite the fact that it's thinner. I don't know anything about this performer. This video is really about the Abe Lincoln poster, so everything else is icing on the cake. When people collect movie posters, serious collectors tend to favor buying the posters which were printed for the first release of the movie. If the movie was popular, it may have been re-released at a later date, in which case a new poster would be printed, but more than likely would be based on the original poster and would therefore be a re-released version of the original poster and not quite as valuable on the collector's market. A lot of times re-release posters are printed in black and white or black and white in one color, so it sort of helps you to differentiate between the original release and the re-release. This Gene Autry poster is a re-release poster, but I love the coloring on it.
Well, we've got him linen-backed, and he's flattened out, and all the rips have come together, and we're going to let him dry. And he's sharing the screen with the spoilers, with Gary Cooper and with Gene Autry under Fiesta Stars, and best of all, Abe Lincoln in Illinois with Raymond Massey. So he's got good company. We've been letting Abe Lincoln dry.
I am now trimming down the poster and leaving 1 inch extra border. This way, when the poster goes to a framer, the framer has the option of trimming down that extra border to what he wants it to be to serve as overlap in the frame, depending on how much overlap he needs. So I generally leave 1 inch. In some cases, customers want more than 1 inch. In other cases, customers want me to trim it right down to the edge and leave them no border. And there you have it, another poster flattened out through linen backing at Posterfix. This is Chris. After 33 years of restoring vintage posters, I still look forward to seeing what surprises you're going to send me, so keep it coming. I appreciate it.